Welcome back. Today we'll be solving exercise number 7, which is basically deals with combination of solids. Okay, combination of solids, as we have discussed, it is a combination of two or more solids that are being under different operations, that are maybe like union, subtract, merge. Okay, so all these things comes into picture. So let us solve this very first question, where we have been given with a cube. The height is not mentioned here. You can assume the height in such problems. In most of the cases, the most detailed side, okay, would be the front view. So this part is the front view. So we can start the problem like by clicking on AutoCAD, start the new diagram. First set the units. Then click on the precision to 0, then units to millimeters. Click on OK. Then switch to 3D modeling. After this, you can just click on this pin button or home button. Automatically it will switch to the 3D view. After this, we have to start with the very first question, that has been given with 50 cross 60 cube. Okay, so we can draw it in multiple ways. I am just making a simpler part of it. So click on the line command. Make sure the ortho is on. Ortho mode should be on before you start this problem. So the very first thing is, so at this side it is 50 and the other side it should be 60. Then again it is 60. Sorry. This side should be 50. Then you can just give a join. Okay, make sure it is joining, else while making a region there will be a problem. Okay, so this is basically one part of the problem, after which you have to consider certain things. So from this line there is an offset of 10 mm of the figure. So first to create an offset of this particular line. So that is a distance which is 10 mm. Then select the object which need to be offsetted. Okay, so give an enter. Okay, so the moment you just take your cursor, automatically there will be a line which is of 10 mm offset. Okay, so but in the problem it is given as 10 mm away. So create offset. Select this object. Okay, so now exactly at the center of this you start making a triangle. Since it is an equilateral triangle, you can just make ortho off. Okay, so the interior part is not mentioned where it is located, but I am assuming it to be exactly at the center. So inwards of 20 mm you just make one more offset line. Offset distance of 20. Now you just select the object. Okay, this side it has to be there. Give an enter. So draw a vertical line that is joining both the offset lines, right? From here, make sure this line is to be 30. Okay, so 15 on either sides I'll just make. Join these two ends in order to make the equilateral triangle. After this, use the command join to merge all the triangular lines. Then delete the central line. So now this is a single entity. Okay, you can delete this line also. After this, you can join the peripheral cube. Then create a region using region command. Okay, it's already been created. So only thing what you have to do is now you have to extrude it. So you can use the command extrude. Select the first thing, give an enter, extrude it to 20 and select the second object for extrusion using extrude command, or maybe you can select this ribbon option, that is the icon over here. Select the second object to 25 so that it will get highlighted. So when you just click on this shades of gray, automatically it should display this thing. Okay, so don't merge them or don't create a union out of them. Keep them as such because nothing is mentioned in the question. But make sure you just make these two objects like this only. Okay, the alignment should not be changed. Okay, so you have to select for creating a layout, you have to select view, base, model from space. Select both the objects, give an enter, layout 1. So you can choose any of the views. So this is how it looks. Okay, so you have to give annotation for all the things. So choose mostly the linear dimensioning. Select these two endpoints. It has to be 10. It's already given in the question. And the second one, the tip and the bottom part, okay, or the central part should be 20. That's also given in the question. Then you can take any two sides and give the dimensioning part. 60. Okay, so use dim style in order to avoid the maximum number of precision points. Click on modify, use dim style as the command, select the precision to 0, click on OK, then set current, click on close. So automatically it gets highlighted. Okay, so if you want to further give other detailing like the thickness of the cube and all, select linear dimensioning. Okay, so like this it has to be